So I got this new chair. It's actually only $3. So anyway, that's not what this video is about. I really like this chair though. But if you haven't already figured out from my channel, I like carbs. This is what my lunch is. I've already gone halfway through it. Look at this. There's sugar in here. I'm addicted. Just addicted. All right, so I'm pretty fed up with the documentary Fed Up. It's really annoying that so many people are being misled to saying that sugar is the problem. Sugar is causing people to have diabetes, and sugar is why people are so obese. Like, I get fucking pissed because it's not true. I mean, let's look at the facts, okay? Let's look at actual human physiology, not this bro science that this low-carb community and anti-sugar bullshit is all about. No, I'm not saying that sugar is a health food, because it's not. It doesn't have all the any of the fiber at all. It doesn't have any water content. Doesn't have any vitamins, minerals, any phytonutrients, stuff like that. So it's not a health food. But is it the reason that people are getting fat? Is it the reason that there's such a huge obesity epidemic and soon to be pandemic? No, that's not at all. Because the fact is, you only actually need 15 grams of fat a day. And that's for your brain, that's for your nervous system, that's for your organs that need to be coated in fat. Fat is very essential, but you just because something is important doesn't mean that you need a lot of it. And that's what a lot of people think. Oh, fat, oh, make sure you get all your omega-3s, because omega-3s are good for you, so that means you need a lot of them. Fucking false. All right, I'm just going to tell you that right now. So you only need about 15 grams of carbs a day. And depending on your activity level and your body size and stuff like that, you need varying amounts of protein depending on your gender and whatnot. But protein is also very overestimated, like how much protein you actually think. Humans only need very small amounts of protein. An example I'm going to give you is a baby, okay? A baby's going to double in size in a matter of months, okay? A bodybuilder is never going to double in size. I don't care how many steroids they're taking. I don't care if they're taking trenbolone. I don't care if they're on insulin, human growth hormone. It does not matter. They will not double in size, ever, okay? And a lot of people think that they need like absurd amounts of protein when the human baby is going to double in size in a matter of months, and the protein content of mother's breast milk is around 7%. So you're telling me that even though you're not going to double in size in months, you need more protein than someone who is going to double in size in a matter of months? No, you won't. So now that we got fat out of the way and got protein out of the way, what other sort of macronutrients are you going to eat? Definitely not alcohol, because that's another thing. People always forget that alcohol is a macronutrient, but that's got 7 calories per gram, fun fact. But, people aren't going to be eating alcohol. Obviously they drink it. So the other macronutrient is, of course, carbohydrates. 4 calories per gram, just like protein. And the reason that you need a lot of carbohydrates is because, unlike fat, which carbohydrates and protein are your two main energy sources in the body, fat, the average person has around 60,000 to 100,000 calories of excess stored fat, just energy for a rainy day when you're gonna be starving, which most time doesn't happen to people in the first world countries. So you have 60,000 to 100,000 calories of excess stored fat. You know how many calories of carbohydrates you can store at a time? Around 2,000. Okay, so you need to constantly be eating carbohydrates to refill your glycogen stores, because you're going to be continually burning carbohydrates. And fat, you don't have to worry about eating fat in order to burn fat. In order to burn fat, you just do low-intensity things. That's it. When you're sleeping, you're burning almost exclusively fat. Because you can never burn 100% fat, because fat burns in the flame of carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are always burning. When you're doing very high-intensity things, you're burning exclusively carbohydrates. When you're doing pretty low-intensity things, you're burning primarily fat. And like somewhere in the middle, it's basically like a crossover. Like, say you're burning fat, you're burning a lot of fat down here, you're burning like almost no carbohydrates. Like I said, you can never burn so almost no carbohydrates. And then you do more intense activity, one goes down, the other goes up, they're about in the middle. And then this goes all the way down when you're like sprinting and you're burning exclusively carbohydrates. Now, you can burn protein for energy, and that's around 2 to 15% of your total energy expenditure will be from protein. So if you follow a higher carbohydrate diet, it's going to be closer to 2% of your total calories of protein are going to be burnt off as energy. And if you are following a more high-fat diet, it's going to be closer to 15%. So if you're eating a high carbohydrate diet, you're following basically a protein sparing diet. So basically the protein that you do eat is going to go to recovering your muscles, growing your hair, growing your teeth, growing your nails, growing your bones. And if you follow a high fat diet, some of it, it's still going to do that, but some of it is also going to be used as energy, which is very inefficient by the body. So what I'm trying to say is all of these documentaries are sending people in the wrong direction. You should be eating a lot of carbohydrates. The only way you could ever eat too many carbohydrates is if you're eating too many total calories. And it's hard to do that in a high carbohydrate diet. All you have, because there's a difference between eating as much as you want and eating as much as you can. Eating as much as you want is eating till you're full and satiated and like you don't really feel like eating anymore. Eating as much as you can is called being a pig. Like, oh, I'm so full, but I'm just gonna keep on eating. I mean, sure, occasionally I'll do that, but if you do that every single day, day after day, then you will get fat. But that's not why people are fat, because of overconsumption of food in general. It's because of overconsumption of fat, because it's really hard to get fat on a high carbohydrate diet. I mean, if you really, really try to do it, I'm sure maybe you could do it, but it would be really difficult. It's not hard to do with fat though, because fat has 9 calories per gram versus carbohydrates, which have 4. And just had to get that off my chest, because it's really annoying when I hear people just saying so matter-of-factly that sugar and carbs are the reason that people are so overweight. And people have been saying that for the last couple of years, and it's not doing anything. It's not helping anyone. Going vegan would help not only people's waistlines, it would help the planet, because you're not going to be using as many resources, and it would help all the animals. Obviously, you're not going to be killing and torturing them and stuff. So it would help the planet, because whenever you eat, say, beef, I think beef is like a 7-to-1 feed conversion ratio. So every time you eat 1 pound of beef, that means that that animal had to consume 7 pounds of grains, which most commercial livestock is fed soy, oats, and corn, I believe. So they have to eat 7 pounds of that for every 1 pound of meat that you get from those animals. You know how fucking inefficient that is? It's inefficient as fuck, roughly. That's a scientific term. And then they also have to consume a bunch of water to stay alive, too. So it's just terrible for the environment, saying shit like that. Like, you have to be in, like, a low-carb diet and avoid sugar. Eat more plants, eat less animal products, and you'll lose the weight.